Hard to believe a story like this in the United States. A young man locked in a tiny cell and simply forgotten, left for days without any food or water. Now the final chapter in this real-life horror story is emerging. Let's bring in Brian Todd. He's been checking the latest. What are you finding out?
Well, this young man, Daniel Chong, has just reached a $4.1 million settlement with the U.S. government. He was never charged in this case, but still placed in that cell for 4.5 days, as Wolf mentioned, with nothing. No food, no water, nothing. He came close to death, his lawyers say, and we got a chance to speak with him about it.
He was left for 4.5 days in a windowless cell. No food or water the entire time. No one even checked on him. He was never formally arrested or charged. This didn't happen in a lawless, developing country. It happened in San Diego to an American college student, Daniel Chong.
So I did go crazy.
Chong has just reached a $4.1 million settlement with the U.S. government. His nightmare began on April 21st of last year. Chong was visiting a friend at a house in the San Diego area when agents from the Drug Enforcement Administration burst in. They seized thousands of ecstasy pills, other drugs, and guns. Chong admitted he'd smoked pot there, but knew nothing of the other contraband. When they took him to a DEA holding cell...
They said they wouldn't charge you. What else did they tell you?
They said they'll come get me in a minute to take me home.
Minutes, hours, days passed. No food, water, or toilet facilities. His lawyer says Chong was in total darkness the last 2 days.
What did you do to survive?
Eventually, your survival instincts do kick in, and you start to realize what you have to do, which is just drink any fluid that's around, which is my urine at the time. And I went ahead and did that.
He hallucinated, he says, so desperate at one point, he bit into his glasses, broke them, and...
Well, I tried to carve a message saying, sorry, Mom, onto my arm. But I didn't finish that.
Did you call out? Did you try to get their attention in any way?
Of course I did. I don't think anybody would sit there and meditate. I was kicking and screaming.
Finally, someone opened the cell. Chong's lawyers say he spent 3 days in an ICU, had kidney failure, dehydration. He'd lost 15 pounds.
The DEA apologized to Chong. A Justice Department investigation ensued. Neither the DEA nor the Justice Department will comment now beyond that. But Chong's lawyers say that because no criminal intent was found, no one would be prosecuted.
Chong and his lawyers say they do believe it was all accidental. Martin Horn, who ran the New York City Department of Corrections, says a key question is whether DEA had rules in place for incarceration.
They are an investigations agency. They're not a corrections agency. They are neither equipped nor trained nor organized to supervise people who are held in confinement.
One of Chong's lawyers says at the time he was held, there were no written policies on the treatment of DEA detainees in those cells. But she says as a result of this case, the agency has put new rules in place to make sure that detainees are treated humanely. Wolf.
How's Daniel Chong doing now?
He's doing well. He's studying economics at the University of California, San Diego. He says he's going to buy his family a house with the settlement money.
All right. Let's hope he has a successful and happy life from now on.
Sure.
Thanks very much, Brian, for that report. Up next, George Zimmerman, apparently armed, pulled over by police. We're getting new information about his traffic stops and the internet star who dances with a raccoon.